the only medications that have been shown to reduce plaque buildup or to cause plaque regressions are the high-dose statins and medications that will reduce cholesterol, such as the PCSK9 inhibitors. Although the amount of plaque regression seen with these drugs are actually very, very small, nonetheless, they have been shown to be very effective in reducing cardiovascular mortality and improving survival in patients with heart disease.
But really, when we talk about plaque regression by these medications, we are really looking at really microscopic level, meaning reducing blockages from maybe 51% to 49%, 48%, meaning these blockages are still there, but the reduction is seen when we do a research study, we can see a microscopic change. But this does not translate to a clinically significant regression as far as the plaque size is concerned. However, having said all that, it is important to take these medications which will stabilize the plaques. It's important that we may not be able to regress the plaque completely, but these medications can prevent progression of the plaques. And I think that's the key thing. We are talking about preventing the progression of the blockage. So why are we taking these medications? There are medications that we give to heart patients, such as the statins, which I mentioned before, antiplatelet agents, anti-inflammatory drugs, such as aspirin, clopidogrel, and these medications all work in conjunction to reduce the progression of these blockages or plaques, which means we're trying to prevent these blockages from progressing from a 30% blockage to a 40% blockage to a 70-80%, and becomes a critical stenosis. So if we can stabilize a plaque at 30% and it does not progress any further, then that's good. If you have a 30% plaque at the age of 30, and you can stabilize that 30% plaque for the next 30, 40, 50 years of your life, that 30% plaque is not going to kill you. But if you don't take your medications, then there's a much more rapid progression of these plaques or blockages from 30% to 40%. And then, you have a critical stenosis when you have limiting chest pains at 70% or more. What these medications do is that it can turn a soft plaque into a vulnerable plaque, what we call a vulnerable plaque, into a more stable plaque which will not rupture. Because plaque rupture is what causes a heart attack. When the plaque is unstable, which is lipid rich, when there's shear stress on the blood vessels, sometimes this plaque can rupture, causing formation of blood clots and leading to a myocardial infarction or a heart attack.
Thank you for watching. I hope you like the video. If you do, please don't forget to like, share and comment. Thank you.